So I just wanted to address a few things about the debate between Bad Mouse Productions and Anarchyball. Yes, that Anarchyball. BMP keeps going on about these co-ops, but I'm not sure he's really familiar with the data he's giving, just like he was unfamiliar with anarcho-capitalism while being ANCAPed, and he's currently unfamiliar with anarcho-whatever it is now. He has even said that he hasn't read any libertarian books while he was in ANCAPs and just watched some of the Free to Choose series and some sporadic YouTube videos, and even now says that he hasn't even finished the 100-page Conquest of Bread book. Yeah, but here he is speaking for it. I digress. BMP, in his latest video to Anarchyball, links two sources to an article titled "But Why No Cooperatives?" which both want you to pay $30 in order for you to read. I don't know if you're aware of this, but not all of us are in college and have access to the LexisNexis or whatever it's called, so we can get free access to all these papers. And I'm not going to dip $30 into reading it, but we don't need to, because the abstract says enough. That and the next link, which he doesn't really give a title for, which was kind of confusing at first, but basically expands on the abstract of the previous link. It basically is trying to explain away the problems that were illustrated in a previous video that I did, link below, reading a study about hierarchical preferences in humans. That humans say they don't like hierarchy, but prefer it in their actions, and when they attempt to create horizontal organizations, hierarchies inevitably emerge, because hierarchical systems are a part of human nature. And don't give me the blank slate shit, I'll just refer you to Pinker again. From the abstract of the paper, Section 1 says that co-ops don't fail because of competition from hierarchical organizations so much. It's just that people's preferences change once they're inside, they discriminate, or suffer something from the outside. Anything is subject to external forces, so c'est la vie. But the other things, because as the paper I read says, humans prefer to work in a homogeneous hierarchical organization, and they reflect that in how they associate without realizing it. Section 2 says, only rarely do we find cooperatives in their pure form, because there's some form of private ownership, pay differences, or hierarchy, and once they get big enough, they just become like any other firm. Because, again, the paper I cited says that hierarchy exists in all organizations, including the ones that tout itself to be truly horizontal. So Section 3 expands on how these co-ops turn private once they get too big. Do I really need to say this again? I'm not going to. You just heard me say it twice. But sorry, co-op sucks because hierarchy is inevitable and it's in our bones and we can't change it because tabula rasa is trash. I mean, even Molyneux has given up on this stance. Bad Mouse Production gives stats by the UN that show that how co-ops and collectives are superior to helping poor people. On a side note, two of the three sources are the Cooperative College for the Department of International Development. Yeah, they're not biased. But that's not exactly what it's saying. What it's saying is that co-ops can be used to help impoverished countries help poor people to create wealth. And I don't disagree with that. However, in other areas where firms are allowed to, by the state, or there are no states to restrict them, hierarchical firms would dominate because people prefer them, and horizontal firm would evolve into hierarchical ones to compete, unless some shit cock burns it down, but that's another video. Anyways, worms.